Hey everyone, I'm Jim Bennett, I'm a Cloud Developer Advocate, and today I want to show off an app that I've been building in my spare time. I thought it would be fun to create an online photo sharing app. So I needed to build a mobile app for this, and I needed some form of backend with storage and some AI capabilities up in the cloud. So this picture I've got here shows the kind of architecture I wanted to build. I want to build a mobile app, runs on iOS and Android, maybe desktop and Windows as well. I wanted some form of backend, I want content moderation, to make sure that nobody's uploading anything a little bit naughty. I want some kind of storage for those photos. I want automatic captioning of those photos so that visually impaired users can take advantage of my app. And then I need a way to store this information and download it. So the technology I'm using for this, on the mobile side, I'm going for Xamarin. Xamarin is the only fully cross-platform native mobile application framework. So you can write 100% native apps on iOS and Android with 100% access to all the SDKs. You can take advantage of extensions and Siri shortcuts and any capability that you can do with the native platform, but you can do it using a .NET language. So you can do it in C# or F#. And because you're using one language, you can actually share code between the different platforms, meaning that you only have to write a small part of your app more than once. So even a thing called Xamarin Forms, which is an abstraction layer, sits on top, allows you to build your UI just once. And you can kind of get up to like 90-95% of code reuse if you want to, using Xamarin, still with 100% API access. For the backend, I'm going to use Azure Functions, because hey, serverless is cool. If you haven't seen Azure Functions, they're little small bits of code that can be triggered by REST calls or items being put in a queue. And these functions can be bound to other capabilities. I'm going to use Azure Storage, so I'm going to use a blob storage for my photos, table storage for my metadata, and then I'm going to use the Azure Cognitive Services to do content moderation, make sure there's nothing naughty, and provide captions for my photos. So I'm going to build my code in C#. I want to build my iOS app, my Android app, my Windows app, and my Azure Functions in the same technology. By doing it in C#, I can share code between both platforms. But if you want, you can build Azure Functions using F#, Java, JavaScript, whatever takes your fancy. So here is my Azure Function project. You can create these in Visual Studio with right-click, add Azure Functions project. And this is my first function here. This allows me to upload a photo to the cloud. Now, these functions are all driven through various forms of binding. This is how you tell the function runtime, the thing that makes this work, how to connect your function to various services. So for example, I have this HTTP trigger. This tells the function's runtime that this piece of code should listen to an HTTP request. This request is listens for as a post that comes into photo/name. So if I go to my website /photo/1234, this will then do a post to 1234. So I can build up a REST API pretty much just by adding an attribute to a request entry, a parameter that comes into my function. So this brings my photo in. I can send it in as a base64 encoded string because that's how I roll. But then I want to put this photo into blob storage. I don't need to write the code to connect to blob storage. I can just use another attribute in my code to say, hey, create a connection to the blob storage, the photos collection. And the blob in question should have the same name as the request that came in. I want write access, I want to use a connection string in my settings, and then give me a stream that I can then write to. And then with that stream, I can just write my data. I don't need to create a connection to blob storage. This is handled for me by the function's runtime. So much code I don't have to write. Now I want to make sure this photo is allowed, doesn't contain anything naughty. So I've got a function, an internal method in here that uses the content moderator client. This is one of the Azure Cognitive Services, allows me to filter content for racy images or adult images. And I can just call it, pass it the image, and it tells me whether it's adult or racy. Got more functions here for triggers. I've got a blob trigger. Whenever a blob's updated, this calls this function. I can then use the computer vision client to create a caption of the image and then return this caption as an object from this function, and that automatically gets inserted into a table for me. So I don't have to do the hard work. It's all done for me. And this is fantastic. And then I can run this functions. I can run it locally, or I can deploy this to GitHub, push it up to the cloud. And that gives me a whole functions API running up in the cloud, a whole REST API. And then once it's up in the cloud, if I want to add things like authentication, it's really easy. I can just turn on authentication. I can configure it to use a Microsoft account or Facebook or Google, add a little bit of code to my mobile app, and suddenly I've got full authentication. You can only use my REST API if you've been authenticated. So this is how you can build an AI-powered photo sharing app that runs in the cloud, all built using Azure Functions, and everything I'm doing in this app can be done using the free account. You can spin up a Functions app, you can have some storage, and you've got up free tiers for AI. All this stuff available for free. So thank you for watching. If you've enjoyed this, please subscribe to the Azure YouTube channel, where there's going to be a whole lot more content showing you the cool things that you can build with the Azure free account. If you want to get in touch, I'm on Twitter at Jim Bob Bennett. There's a GitHub link with all the code for this below this video. Thank you very much.